Hello everyone, this is Nirupama and welcome to Simplify. Today I'm going to talk about 5 ways by which you can increase the intake of iron in your diet. Iron deficiency is the most common and widespread nutritional disorder in the world. The numbers are staggering. 2 billion people, about 30% of the world's population, are anemic, mainly due to iron deficiency. Iron, as you know, is a mineral that is crucial to our bodies for making the protein hemoglobin, which in turn transports oxygen to all the vital organs of our body. Iron deficiency might be subtle in its manifestations, which might include ill health, weakness and fatigue, affect the cognitive development in children, and so on. The highest amount of iron is found in meat, which includes all kinds of meat like seafood, poultry and pork. This kind of iron is known as the heme iron. On the other hand, the iron that we get from plant sources like cereals, legumes, fruits and vegetables is known as non-heme iron. But just because you're consuming a lot of iron-rich foods does not mean that all the iron is getting absorbed in the body. The bioavailability of iron is very low, which means that not all the consumed iron is absorbed efficiently by the body. The heme iron that is found in meats is absorbed 2 to 7 times more efficiently than non-heme iron. Absorption of heme iron is also not affected by dietary factors. However, non-heme iron, that is plant sources, still account for a significant contribution of iron in the diet. So here are 5 ways by which you can increase the absorption of iron in your body, especially if you are a vegetarian and dependent on plant-based sources of iron. Number 1, increase the intake of vitamin C. Vitamin C or ascorbic acid transforms the non-heme iron into a form that is more readily absorbed by our body. So if you're consuming iron-rich foods, it might be a good idea to accompany them with vitamin C-rich foods like citrus, bell peppers, broccoli, etc. Number 2, consume soaked, cooked and germinated foods. Cereals and legumes are a good source of iron, but they also contain phytates, a class of compounds that inhibit the absorption of iron by our body. Processes like soaking, cooking, and germination reduce the level of phytates in cereals and legumes and therefore help in the better absorption of iron. Number 3, keep the calcium intake in check. The mineral calcium, which is found in milk and milk products, competes with the absorption of iron in our body. So, for example, kids who consume a lot of milk might have the risk of iron deficiency if their iron-rich meals are accompanied with calcium-rich foods. Number 4, do not consume tea or coffee with meals. Tea and coffee contain a group of compounds known as polyphenols, which inhibit the absorption of iron from non-heme sources. So it might be a good idea to consume your tea or coffee between the meals instead of with your meals. Number 5, iron fortification and supplementation. You can also increase the intake of iron by consuming foods that are fortified with iron, for example, iron fortified cereals. Or you might also include iron supplements in your diet. Now, should you be worried about the iron levels in your body? Most people do not need to worry about it, but it's also good to know the food chemistry part of it. So go get a blood test, and if your iron levels are fine, continue with your existing diet. And if not, you could consult a nutritionist and discuss meal plans in a way that increase the absorption of iron in your body. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please like and comment on the video and do subscribe to my channel.